Okay. Bagong lesson naman. This is again one of the methods of solving first order differential equation. So ang ating form usually ng first order differential equation is in the form of axy dx. So this is a function of x comma y plus b times the function of x comma y dy is equal to 0. So it is exact. So kailangan muna natin ma-identify kung the differential equation or the given differential equation is exact. So we can have it checked if and only if, or the differential equation is exact if and only if the partial derivative of a xy, dahil with respect to x yun, so dapat ang pag-partial derivative mo with respect to y. So if it happens na ito ay with respect to y or dy, dapat with respect to x ito. Yung other variable siya. So again, the d is exact if partial derivative of the first term with respect to y is equal to partial derivative naman itong second term na to. So since dy with respect to x tayo dito. So if and only if, sabi nga, the given differential equation is exact, meron tayong mga steps na susundin. So ito yung mga steps na isulat ko na siya. So if the given differential equation is exact, so ito yung given natin kanina na first order differential equation is exact. So here are the steps. So illustrate natin siya by solving problems. So again, kinuha ko ulit itong mga exercises or itong mga isinusolve nating problems dun sa libro pa rin na Engineering Differential Equations by Sir Bravo, Sir Gomez, at saka kay Sir Cruz. So, tapos, i-step by step na natin siya. So, since meron na tayong suggested steps dito, ito yung given. So, given example number 1, ito yung number 1, page 41 of your book. So, ang given doon is x plus y dx plus x minus y plus 1 dy is equal to 0. So, diba, sa mga methods na na-discuss natin, so, variable separable ba? First order, diba pag sinabing variable separable, literally, isi-separate natin yung variable na x at saka y para maging integrable. So, in this case, we can't separate x from y or y from x. So, hindi siya separable. So, yung susunod nating method ay homogeneous coefficient. The coefficient is homogeneous if and only if all the terms are of the same degree. So, meron akong degree 1, degree 1, degree 1, degree 1, tapos ito may degree 0 dahil may constant. So, di ba yung 1 meron siyang ka-multiply na x to the 0. So, ang degree niya ay 0. So, since because of this positive 1 here, hindi na siya magiging homogeneous. So, method 2, x na. So, yung method 3 naman is linear in two variables. If the coefficient ay gives linear in two variables. So, ito nga. So, x plus y is linear in two variables. X minus y plus 1 is also linear in two variables. So, kaso, dun sa na-discuss natin na method na yun, napakahaba ang gagawin. So, i-replace muna natin yung x with h and y with k, then solve for the value of h and k, tapos gagamit pa tayo ng substitution na masyadong marami. So, since nga, masyadong mahaba yung method na yan, let us try to introduce another method kasi baka exact. So, kasi kung exact siya, mas malilesen natin yung solution. So, syempre, ang unang-una natin gagawin para magamit natin tong apat na step na to, so we need to identify first whether the given differential equation is exact. Paano ulit? If the partial derivative of A with respect to Y is equal to the partial derivative of B with respect to X. So, dapat yun muna natin ang i-identify natin. So, let us try the exactness of the given DE. So, ang sabi, if this represents your A and this represents your B, so this is A dx, B dy. So, dapat daw ang partial derivative ng A with respect to Y, kasi X yun, must be equal to partial derivative ni B with respect to X. So, dapat mapatunayan natin na ang partial derivative niyan ay equal para magamit natin yung mga steps na nakasulat dito sa papel. So, check natin kung ay exact siya. So, sabi dito, partial derivative of A. So, I need to take the partial derivative of X plus Y with respect to Y. Dapat daw equal siya sa partial derivative ni X minus Y plus 1 with respect to X. So, as you can see, we are differentiating with respect to Y. So, therefore, X is considered constant. So, the derivative of a constant is always 0. So, derivative of Y with respect to Y is 1. Equal ba siya with the partial derivative nung X minus Y plus 1 with respect to X? Again, our variable na i-differentiate ay with respect to X. So, non-X are treated constant. So, therefore, Y is treated constant and the derivative of a constant is 0. Derivative of 1 is also 0 because 1 is also a constant. So, derivative of X with respect to X is 1. So, as you can see, it's linaw na linaw. They are equal. So, therefore, the DE is exact. So, once napatunayan natin na ang differential equation given ay exact, so, focusin na tayo sa unang step. Ang sabi dito, integrate AXY DX with respect to X, of course. So, since with respect to X ito, we have to treat Y as constant. At itatago daw natin sa pangalang Q yung kasagutan. So, ano ba yung A natin kanina? So, ang A natin kanina ay X plus Y DX. So, you have to integrate this first daw. So, let us try to integrate. So, integral of X plus Y DX. So, yan daw yung i-integrate natin because that's your first step. Integrate AXY DX. So, treating Y as constant. So, if Y is treated constant, so, di ba ang constant inilalabas lang natin. So, let us try to solve this. So, this is integral of X DX plus Y integral of DX. Since nga, Y is treated constant, so, you have to put that outside the integral sign. Dinistribute lang natin, ha? And this gives you 1 half x squared plus y integral of dx is x plus, di ba dapat pagkatapos natin mag-integrate, mag-a-add tayo dapat supposedly ng c. So, dapat mag-a-add ako dito ng c. Kaso, since hindi pa naman talaga totally tapos yung integration, diba, we have treated y as constant. So, instead of adding c, I need to add a function of y since I have treated that function of y as constant. So, instead of adding c, since y is treated constant, ang i-add ko ngayon ay function of y, p of y, say for example. So, pwede namang gawin mong k of y, c of y, h of y, ikaw ang bahala. So, this is a function of y, p of y. So, ang sabi, sa pagkatapos ng step 1, itatago muna daw natin siya sa pangalang q. So, you have to let the result sa step 1 be your q. So, ito na yung magiging q natin. So, that's step 1. Ang sabi ng step 2, take the partial derivative of Q with respect to Y. So, syempre, you have to treat X as constant naman. So, your Q here is ito. Sabi ni step 2, ito yung step 1. Sabi ni step 2, I need to take the partial derivative of Q with respect to Y. So, that is partial derivative of 1 half X squared plus XY plus P of Y with respect to Y. So, if that is with respect to Y, you have to treat X constant. So, therefore, this first term, 1 half X squared is 0 because the derivative of a constant is 0. Again, X is treated constant. So, that's why its derivative is 0. Then, X is constant, inilalabas lang. So, X times derivative of Y is 1 plus partial derivative of a function of y with respect to y. So, that gives you a function of y prime. Since kinuha mo yung derivative ng function of y with respect to y. So, ito na yung sagot dun sa partial derivative of y with your q with respect to y. So, sabi dito, then equate to BXY. So, ibig sabihin, yung daw makukuha nating sagot, i-equate natin sa BXY. So, ang sagot natin dito ay ito. So, i-equate daw natin siya sa B, X, Y. So, what's X times 1? So, that's X. So, kakopy ko lang muna ito, ha? So, this is X times 1 is X plus P prime of Y is equal to B, X, Y. So, that is B, X, Y. So, remember, step 2 pa lang ang ginagawa natin. So, BXY ay ito. X minus Y plus 1. So, i-equate daw natin yung sagot na yon dun sa value ng BXY. So, this is X plus P prime of Y is equal to X minus Y plus 1 since that's your BXY. So, simplifying, sabi kasi dito sumunod, then simplify. So, you need to simplify this by transposing this x on the right side of the equation. So, if I'm going to transpose that x on the right, that x cancels out. So, which gives you p prime of y is equal to negative y plus 1. So, ang aim dito, makikita mo na nasa tamang track ka pa if ang natira sa step 2 is purely function of y. So, again, malalaman mo kung nasa right track ka pa if this is integrable. So as you can see, you have this prime here. So the only way para ma-eliminate natin kasi yung prime na yan is to integrate. So kailangan ko siyang i-integrate para makuha ko yung P of Y. So that yung P of Y ko dito, makukuha ko na yung value. Dun kay Q, makukuha ko na yung value niya. So, from there, if I'm going to integrate, this P of Y now is equal to integral of negative Y plus 1 dy. So, that is P of Y is equal to negative integral of Y dy plus integral of dy by distributing. Then, P of Y here is negative 1 half Y squared plus integral of the derivative is Y. Then, tsaka ako maglalagay ng plus C. So, having this P of Y solved, babalikan naman natin yung Q. Kasi sabi dito, sa step 4, finally, you have to substitute this to Q. Kasi we are done with step 3 na in-integrate yung result with respect to Y. So, balikan si Q. Ang Q natin kanina ay yung na-solve natin na 1 half x squared plus yx that can be written as xy plus P of Y. So, since na-solve na natin yung P of Y, which is this one, so this is 1 half x squared plus xy minus 1 half y squared because that's the value of P of y plus C is equal to 0. So, di ba yung C na to, pag transpose ko, magiging negative C. Negative constant is still a constant. So, you need not to put the negative sign or positive kasi whether it is negative or positive, it is still a constant. So, this can be simplified to 1 half x squared plus xy minus 1 half y squared plus y is equal to C. So, that must be my answer. So, if I am to check the answer, so, this is page 41 of our book. So, pwede nating i-check dito yung sagot. So, ang nakuha nating sagot kanina is 1 half xy, 1 half x squared, minus 1 half y squared. I think this is the answer, yung letter B. 1 half x squared minus 1 half y squared plus xy plus y is equal to C. So, therefore, our answer is yung letter B or yung second choice, yung nandito. So, ito yung magiging sagot natin. So, ganun lang. It's more of procedural. Basta malaman natin na siya ay exact, pauulit-ulitin lang natin tong steps na to. So, ito lang ang magsisilbing gabay natin tungo sa tagumpay para makasolve tayo ng exact differential equation. So, let us try another example. So, we have here number 4, page 41, na nasa libro ulit. So, y sine 2 phi plus 1 d phi plus sine squared phi plus tangent y minus 2 dy is equal to 0. So, first again is to check whether the given differential equation is exact. By, remember, this represents your A, this represents your B. So, kailangan nating makuha ang partial derivative ni A with respect to, so remember, kung phi yun, dapat yung other variable ang ating kukunin. So, that's with respect to Y. And that must be equal daw to partial derivative ni B. So, since dy yun, dapat with respect to phi tayo. So, dapat makuha natin ito na equal para masabi natin na siya ay exact. So, taking the partial derivative of A with respect to Y. So, this is partial derivative of Y sine 2 phi plus 1 with respect to Y must be equal to, so this is still a question mark, partial derivative ni sine squared phi plus tangent Y minus 2 with respect to phi. So, yung una muna natin. So, in this case, you are to differentiate with respect to Y. So, if I'm going to differentiate with respect to Y, that phi is considered constant. So, if that's a constant, I have to put that outside the operator. So, ang operator natin dito is derivative. So, this is sine 2 phi, that's a constant, multiplied by the derivative of Y with respect to Y, which is 1, plus the derivative of 1 is 0. And that must be daw, question mark, equal to the partial derivative of these three terms with respect to phi, treating Y as constant. So, notice, this is tangent Y. Since this is treated constant, so the derivative of tangent Y with respect to phi is 0. And derivative of negative 2 with respect to phi is also 0 because negative 2 is a constant. So, you just have to take the derivative of sine squared phi with respect to phi. So, ano bang derivative ng sine squared? So, gagamit lang tayo ng general power formula, di ba? Ang derivative ng u to the n is n u to the n minus 1 times the derivative of u. So, I need to take the exponent. Ang exponent ko ay 2. So, magkakaroon ako dun ng 2 sine phi to the 2 minus 1. That's 1. And I need to take the derivative of that u. Ano yung derivative neto? So, ang derivative niyan ay cosine of phi. So, as you can see, magkakaroon tayo dito ng sine 2 phi is equal to 2 sine phi. 2 minus 1 is 1. So, sine phi multiplied by cosine phi. So, this is actually equal using the double angle identity for sine. So, alam natin that sine 2 phi is equal to 2 sine phi cosine phi. So, this is equal gamit ang double angle identity. So, using double angle identity, so equal na siya. So, therefore, the DE is exact. So, again, napatunayan na natin siyang exact. I need to take the integral of this first with respect to x. So, since hindi x yung aking variable, kundi phi, so with respect to phi, treating y constant. So, kailangan kong kunin ang integral nito with respect to phi, treating y constant. So, ang gagawin ko, susulat ko muna yung given. So, that is integral of y sine 2 phi plus 1 d phi. So, this is your a. So, i-integrate ko daw yun. A, that's your a. I-integrate ko with respect to phi, treating y as constant. So, if that's treating y as constant, I have to put y outside. So, magiging sine 2 phi d phi plus integral of d phi. So, you just have to distribute that d phi. So, as you can see, ang sine 2 phi, ang integral niyan ay sine u. So, ang u ko dito ay 2 phi. So, I need to provide 2 kasi ang derivative ng 2 phi ay 2 d phi. So, para maging du yun, maglalagay ako ng 2, maglalagay ako ng 1 half outside. So, that magiging siyang negative 1 half y cosine 2 phi since the integral of sine is negative cosine plus d phi. So, ang integral ng d phi, this integral and derivative cancels out. So, magkakaroon ako ng phi. So, again, mag-a-add tayo ng function of y since we have treated y as a constant. So, that is step number 1. So, that's step number 1. So, itatago natin siya sa pangalang Q. So, yung kasagutan daw natin, itatago natin sa pangalang Q. We are done with step 1. So, ang sabi ni step 2, I need to take partial derivative of Q with respect to Y. So, I need to take the partial derivative with respect to Y of negative 1 half Y cosine 2 phi plus phi plus phi of Y. So, I need to take the partial derivative of that with respect to Y. So, ibig sabihin, yung cosine 2 phi is treated constant. So, I have to put that outside. Also, this negative 1 half. So, this is negative 1 half cosine 2 phi, that's a constant, negative 1 half cosine 2 phi, derivative of y with respect to y is 1, plus derivative of phi with respect to y. So since with respect to y, you are treating phi as constant, so derivative of that is 0, and derivative of this is p prime of y. So that gives you p prime of y. So, ang sabi, i-equate daw ito kay bxy. So, again, ikakopy ko muna ulit itong sagot na to dun sa taas. So, this is negative 1 half cosine 2 phi plus p prime of y is equal to bx comma y. So again, itong negative 1 half cosine 2 phi times 1 is negative 1 half cosine 2 phi plus p prime of y, that's plus p prime of y is equal to bxy. So we are still in step 2. So continuation tayo ng step 2. So bxy is ito. So negative 1 half cosine 2 phi plus p prime of y is equal to bxy. So, bxy natin is sine squared phi plus tangent y minus 2. So, that's the value of your bxy. So, ang sabi natin, di ba nabanggit natin kanina, para magkaroon tayo ng right track, kailangan yung nasa right side maging function of y na lang. Kailangan yung nasa right side maging function of y na lang. So, I need to transpose this on the right side of the equation. So, that this gives you p prime of y is equal to sine squared phi plus tangent y minus 2 plus 1 half cosine 2 phi, because that negative 1 half cosine 2 phi transposed to the right becomes positive. So, as you can see, hindi siya function of y lang kasi meron tayo nitong dalawang two terms na to. So, anong gagawin natin? So, using an identity ulit, so sine squared phi kasi is equal to 1 half times the quantity 1 minus cosine twice the angle. So, using that principle. So, an identity 1 half, 1 minus cosine 2 phi. Yun lang ang medyo delikado kasi eh. Paano kung hindi mo alam yung identity na to? So, yun ang medyo problem natin. So, dapat we have to always go back dun sa mga previous na courses natin. So, dapat na master talaga ang trigonometry. So, pag hindi, medyo mahihirapan talaga. So, minus 2 plus 1 half cosine 2 phi. So, by distribution, so this p prime of y now is equal to 1 half minus 1 half cosine 2 phi. If you distribute that 1 half there, plus tangent y minus 2 plus 1 half cosine 2 phi. So, this negative 1 half cosine 2 phi cancels out with that positive 1 half cosine 2 phi. So, this now gives you P of y is equal to tangent of y, 1 half minus 2 is negative 3 halves. So, this is a function of y na. So, we can now proceed to step 3. Sabi ni step 3, i-integrate ko daw siya with respect to y. So, syempre, we have to treat x as a constant. So, wala na pala tayong constant. Kasi nga, function of y na lang siya. So, I need to integrate both sides with respect to y. So, again, integral and derivative cancels out. So, this gives you p of y is equal to integral of tangent y dy minus 3 halves integral of dy. So then p of y is equal to integral of tangent y is equal to sine y dy over cosine y minus 3 halves integral of dy. So, if u is cosine of y, ang derivative niyan ay negative sine y dy. So, para maging du yun, I need to provide negative and compensate with negative. So, this becomes negative integral of derivative of cosine y over cosine y. So, this gives you ln of cosine y. So, the p of y here is negative ln of cosine y minus 3 halves of y, syempre, add c. So, sabi ni step 3, yan na yung isa substitute ko kay q para magawa ko yung step 4. Ang step 4 ko, isa substitute ko daw to doon kay q. So, ang q ko kanina ay negative 1 half y cosine 2 phi plus your q. Ay, sorry, plus your p of y. Sorry. Plus your p of y. But p of y is ito. So, substitute ko lang. So, this is negative 1 half y cosine 2 phi plus phi minus ln cosine y minus 3 halves y plus c is equal to 0. So, I just need to transpose this c on the right. So, it is still c. So, magiging siyang phi minus 1 half y cosine 2 phi minus ln cosine y minus 3 halves y is equal to c. Inuna ko lang yung positive phi kasi mas magandang tingnan kung una ang positive. So, that therefore is our answer. So, again, this is number 4, page 41. So, ito yung mga choices, ito yung sagot. So, phi minus 1 half y cosine 2 phi minus ln cosine y minus 3 halves y is equal to c. So, therefore, our answer is yung first choice. Ang ating sagot ay yung first choice. So, that's example number 2. So, let's proceed with example number 3. So, example number 3, we have 3x minus sine y plus 2y dx, 2x minus x cosine y plus 1 dy is equal to 0, when x is 1, y is 0. So, particular solution na. So, this is number 6, page 41. So, again, check natin yung exactness. This is partial derivative of 3x minus sine y plus 2y with respect to y, kasi nga dx dapat equal sa partial derivative ni 2x minus x cosine y plus 1 with respect to x kasi dy yun. So, partial derivative with respect to y, treating x constant. So, derivative of 3x is 0. So, derivative of negative sine y is negative cosine y. Plus, derivative ni 2y is 2. Equal siya sa partial derivative ni 2x with respect to x, and that's 2, minus cosine y is treated constant, so I need to put that outside, negative cosine y times the derivative of x with respect to x is 1, plus the derivative of 1 is 0. So, notice na ito ay equal. So, therefore, the given differential equation is exact. So, having that exact, pwede na tayong proceed dun sa first step. So, ang first step natin is to integrate the first with respect to x. So, integrate 3x minus sine y plus 2y dx. So, syempre, you just have to integrate this with respect to x. So, this is 3 integral of x dx minus sine y integral of dx plus 2y integral of dx because y is treated constant. So, you have to put negative sine y and 2y outside the integral sign. So, this gives you 3 halves x squared using power formula minus sine y multiplied by x plus 2yx plus a function of y. So, again, this is your q. So, sabi ni step number 1. So, susunod na step is you have to take the partial derivative of this answer with respect to y naman. So take the partial derivative with respect to y. We are doing the step number 2. So this is 3 halves x squared minus x sine y plus 2xy plus p of y. So taking its partial derivative with respect to y, so you have to treat x constant. So the derivative of 3 halves x squared is 0. And since y is our variable, so ang x ang constant, so I have to put that outside. So magiging negative x times the derivative of sine y, which is cosine y, plus 2x again is a constant, so I have to put that outside and take the derivative of y, which is 1, plus p prime of y, because the derivative of p of y with respect to y is p prime of y. Then we have to equate that to q. Ano ba ang q? So, equate natin siya sa b, x, y. So, ang ating bx, y ay yun, 2x minus x cosine y plus 1. So, meron akong negative x cosine of y plus 2x plus p prime of y is equal to the value of your b. So, ang value ng b ko ay 2x minus cosine xy ay cosine y x, minus x cosine y pala. So, minus x cosine y plus 1. Then simplify. So this negative x cosine y is of same term with this negative x cosine y. So if we transpose, that cancels out. And that 2x is equal to that 2x once transpose is negative 2x. So magka-cancel out na lang siya. So magiging p prime of y is 1. So p prime of y is equal to 1. So I just need to integrate. So integrating the 2 with respect to y, then p of y is equal to y plus c. So that's your p of y. So yun ang isa-substitute natin kay q na p of y dito. So let us try to rewrite that. So this is 3 halves x squared minus x sine y plus 2xy plus 2xy plus p of y. Your p of y here is y plus c. So this is plus y plus c is equal to 0. So transposing that c there, so this is 3 halves x squared minus x sine y plus 2xy plus y is equal to c. So this therefore is our general solution. So general solution siya. So, since yan ang general solution, eh, meron tayong particular solution that when x is 1, y is equal to 0. So, ang initial condition natin, kapag karaw ang x ay 1, ang y ay 0. So, substitute lang natin. So, magiging 3 halves, 1 raised to the second power, minus 1, sine of 0, plus 2, times 1, times 0, plus 0, is equal to c. So, sine 0 is definitely 0. So, this is 0. So, 2 times 1 times 0 is 0. This is 0. So, c is definitely 3 halves. So, if c is 3 halves, substitute ko lang dun ay 3 halves. So, magiging 3 halves x squared minus x sine y plus 2xy plus y is equal to 3 halves. So, that's our answer. So, let's check. So, this is number 6, page 41. So, ang mga choices natin ay walang denominator. So, pwede nating tanggalin yung denominator. So, by multiplying this all by 2. So, if I am to multiply your particular solution with 2, so this gives you 3x squared. Because that 2 cancels out, matitira 3x squared na lang. Minus 2x sine y plus 4xy plus 2y is equal to 3. So, i-multiply natin lahat ng terms sa 2. So, this is 3x squared minus 3x squared. Hanapin natin yung 3x squared sa choices. So, ito yung 3x squared. Mayroon tayong minus 2xy. Meron tayong plus 4xy. Meron tayong 2y. At equal siya sa 3. So, ang ating kasagutan ay ito. Kasi wala siyang ABCD, ang hirap naman sabihin eh. So, ito yung ating answer dun sa choices. Okay. Okay. Last na. Let's try. This is number 8, page 42. So again, meron ulit tayong initial condition that when x is 2, y is negative 1. So same step lang. Check the exactness. So take the partial derivative with respect to y of 18xy cubed minus 9y minus 2. Kasi with respect to x. So this is partial derivative of this a with respect to y. Dapat daw equal siya sa partial derivative with respect to x dahil dy yon. Of 27x squared y squared minus 9x plus 3. So, taking the partial derivative with respect to y, treating x constant. So, that gives you 18x is a constant. So, you have to put that outside. And then, take the derivative of y cubed, which is 3y squared minus the derivative of 9y with respect to y is minus 9, and minus derivative of 2 is 0. And that must be equal to partial derivative with respect to x. You have 27y squared because 27y squared is treated constant and the derivative of x squared here is 2x minus 9. So simplifying this further, this 18 and 3 is 54xy squared. Minus 9 is equal to 54xy squared minus 9. So as you can see, 27 times 2 is 54 times x times y squared minus 9. So having that equal, the DE is exact. So since exact yung DE, integrate ulit tayo. So step 1 ulit. Ang step 1, integrate this with respect to x, treating y constant. So integral of 18xy cubed minus 9y minus 2 dx. So treating y as constant. So you have to put 18y cubed integral of x dx minus 9y integral of dx minus 2 integral of dx. So again, this 18y cube is constant, so you have to put that outside. Integral of x dx minus, this is constant, this is also constant, and that must be put outside the integral sign. So this gives you 18y cube x squared over 2 using power formula minus 9y times x minus 2x, of course, plus a function of y since we have treated y as a constant. So this is 9x squared y cubed because 18 divided by 2 is 9 minus 9xy minus 2x plus a function of y. So ito na yung ating mahiwagang q. Then, sabi ni step 2, I need to take the partial derivative of that q with respect to y. So derivative nung sagot with respect to y. So again, treating x as a constant. So since x is a constant, I need to put that outside. 9x squared, derivative of y cubed is 3y squared minus 9x is a constant, derivative of y is 1 minus derivative of 2x, and that's 0 plus p prime of y. So simplifying that gives 27x squared y squared minus 9x plus p prime of y. And that must be equated to b. So, dapat i-equate daw natin siya kay bxy. So, this gives you 27x squared y squared minus 9x plus p prime of y is equal to b. But b is 27x squared y squared minus 9x plus 3. Minus 9x plus 3. Minus 9x plus 3. So that is your B. So again, by simplifying this, cancels out with that. Negative 9x cancels out with that. Gives you P of Y or P prime of Y. B equal to 3. Then integrate na natin siya. Tada! With respect to y. So again, integral and derivative cancels out. So P of y now is 3y plus c. So eto na ulit ang isa-substitute natin kay P of y. So the answer there is 9x squared y cubed 9x squared y cube minus 9xy minus 2x plus p of y is equal to 0. But p of y there is 3y plus c. So, 3y plus c ito. So, copy lang natin. 9x squared y cube minus 9xy minus 2x plus 3y plus c is equal to 0. So, then transpose na lang natin yung plus c ulit. So, magiging 9x squared y cube minus 9xy minus 2x plus 3y is equal to c. So, this will be our general solution. So, may initial condition. Substitute lang natin when x is 2, y is negative 1. So, this is 9. That's 2 squared. That's negative 1 cubed. Minus 9 times 2 times negative 1. Minus 2 times the value of that is 2. Plus 3 times the value of that is c. That's c. So, this is 36 negative because negative 1 cubed is negative 1 times 2 to the second power is 4 times 9 is negative 36 minus 9 times 2 times negative 1 is positive 18 minus 4 minus 3 is equal to c. So, this is negative 36 plus 18 is negative 18 minus 4 is negative 22 minus 3 is negative 25. So, c is negative 25. So, therefore, 9x squared y cubed minus 9xy minus 2x plus 3y is equal to negative 25. So, ang ating kasagutan ay ang sagot natin ay ito, 9x squared y cube 9x squared y cube minus 9xy minus 2x plus 3y plus 25. So, once you transpose this negative 25 on the left, magiging positive 25. So, ang sagot natin ay yung pangalawang choice dito sa baba. So, this is 9x squared y cube minus 9xy minus 2x plus 3y plus 25 is equal to 0. So, that concludes exact equations. Tenen! Mag-aral ng mahusay.